Okay, I have started recording now. So Vaishnav, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so in today's class, we are going to deal with a new topic and that is beams. Just give me a Okay, so we are starting with the reactions of beam. Now in beam, we have already discussed what is a beam, what is the definition of support of beam, but we have not gone through all the types of loads that beam can have. Are you with me, Vaishnav?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so today basically we will be focusing on various types of loads that a beam can have. Can you read the problem number 60 for me?
Determine the reactions at the beam supports for the given loading.
Yes, so we have to determine the reactions for this beam for a given loading. But now look at what kind of loading it is. So if you look at this, the unit of loading is 900 Newton per meter. And if you can look at the loading diagram, it will be seen as rectangular up to this point. So between A and B, the loading diagram is rectangular. Whereas between B and C, the loading diagram is triangular. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So what do we mean by rectangular load? That means that the intensity of loading is remaining constant over the entire portion AB. That means you walk 1 meter on portion AB, and in that 1 meter, you have gained the total load of 900 Newton. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So if you walk 2 meter on this beam, in those 2 meters, you would have gained a load of 900 into 2, that is 1800 Newton per meter. Happy? So this is what we mean by the rectangular load. Rectangular load has also another name, and that is called as uniformly distributed load. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Uniformly distributed load. What are the examples of uniformly distributed load? So I can give you an example. Let us say there is a water tank, and the water is still, nobody is there in the tank, and water level is this one. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So everywhere the height of water column is constant. So this water column is going to apply this uniformly distributed load on its base. Happy?
Yes, sir.
You can as well imagine that this tank is filled with a sand up to certain level, then that sand is also going to have uniformly distributed load on the base. This is the example. So now, what about the other portion? What kind of load prevails on portion BC? So if you look at the intensity of load is 900 Newton per meter at B, and it is zero Newton per meter at C. So the intensity of load itself is decreasing from point to point on BC, but it decreases as a linear function of length. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So this intensity is linearly decreasing. What does it mean? So let us say we are very close to portion B on beam BC. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And let us say we walk 1 mm. 1 mm matlab kitna meter hai? 0.001 meter. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So in that 1 mm, the decrease in intensity is very small. So I can safely say it is constant 900 Newton per meter. So in that 1 mm, how much load I would have acquired? I would have acquired 900 into 0.001, that is 0.9 Newton load. Happy?
Yes, sir.
But now if I consider, if I am somewhere at the midspan of BC, let us say I am somewhere here. So at midspan of BC, what is this intensity? It is 450 Newton per meter. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Now, at this midspan of BC, if I take a walk of 1 mm, this is 0.001 meter. Then what is the load that I gain in this small portion of my walk, I gain the load of 900 in 450 into 0.001, that is 0.45 Newton only. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So the rate at which the load is gained per meter run on the beam itself is decreasing linearly. So such kind of loading we call it as uniformly varying load. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Uniformly varying load. Varying load. Now, what is the example of uniformly varying load? Let us say you have stacked a sand this way in a tank. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So I can split this loading into two parts, one rectangle. So corresponding to this portion of the sand, the weight acts as a uniformly distributed load. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Whereas corresponding to this portion, the weight is acting as a triangular load or uniformly varying load. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So these are the examples of uniformly distributed load and uniformly varying load. Now, uniformly distributed load is also shown by this symbol. ये जो मैंने दिखाया ना, this symbol is also used for uniformly distributed load. And by that, what I mean is, for every meter walk on the beam, I gain the load by constant amount, and that is 900 Newton in this particular case. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now what is asked? For determine the reactions of the beam supports for a given loading. तो कौन-कौन से supports हैं? एक तो support है hinge support, and there is another support which is roller support. This type of beam is called as overhanging beam. Why? Because it is resting on A and B, and it has BC as an overhang over support BC, is over support B. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So we call this beam as overhanging beam. And specifically, it is singly overhanging beam because on the single side, on one side, we have an overhang. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So how are we going to determine the reactions of this beam? So to determine the reactions of this beam, we must draw something called as free body diagram of the beam. Free the beam from all external agencies and show what the external agencies must have been doing. This is free body diagram. So I will free the beam from earth, but nothing is mentioned about the weight of beam. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Therefore, there is no question of showing the self weight. Nothing is mentioned about the self weight. Therefore, free the body from earth, but we will not be able to show anything that earth does on the beam because self weight is negligible. Free the beam from supports. So I freed the beam from supports at A and B. Support at A being hinge support, it can offer only two orthogonal force reactions. Those reactions I have shown as VA and HA. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Then support at B, being roller support, it can offer only upward reaction that I have shown as VB. And I have shown loads. Loads kaise dikhaya? Ye jo rectangular load hai, that I have shown by the another symbol, uniformly distributed load, 900 Newton per meter intensity. And then on portion BC, we have uniformly varying triangular load, which has intensity of 900 Newton per meter at B and 0 Newton per meter at C. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Now, it is very difficult to work with the intensities. So we are going to convert these intensities into forces. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Are you with me? Chalo. So let me ask you the question. If I walk 1 meter on beam AB, how much load would that correspond to? It will correspond to 900 Newton per meter multiplied by 1 meter. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Let us say I walk 1 meter. On this beam, yeah, 1 meter. So in this, on this 1 meter, how much is the load acting? It is 900 Newton per meter multiplied by 1. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So the total load acting here is 900 Newton. How did I arrive at this load? So I simply take the area under the load, 1 meter multiplied by this 900. This is the area under loading diagram. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So how do we calculate total load? Total load corresponding to UDL or UVL. UDL is uniformly distributed load. UVL is uniformly varying load. May it be UDL, may it be UVL. The total load is calculated as area under the loading diagram. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So, अब जरा मुझे बताओ, if I consider the entire span AB, what is the area under loading diagram? The area under loading diagram would be then 900 multiplied by 3. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So, what is the total load corresponding to this uniformly distributed load on portion AB? It is 900 multiplied by 3. So, that 900 multiplied by 3 I have written here. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Now, what is the total load on portion BC? It is area under the loading diagram. So area under the loading diagram is half 1 into 900. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So I have written that here. Dekho, half 900 into 1. This is the area under the loading diagram. Question is now, where do these loads act? Happy?
Yes, sir.
So these loads will act at the centroid of loading diagram. So where is the centroid of this rectangle? Can you locate the centroid of this rectangle? It is at distance 1.5 meter from left. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So centroid of the rectangle at one is at 1.5 meter from the left. So I have shown this 900 into 3 load acting at distance 1.5 meter from left. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Where is the centroid of this triangle? So if I consider this triangle from base, the centroid is located at the distance of 1/3 into height. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So zara dekho kahan pe maine load acting dikhaya hai, 1/3 and 2/3 pe. So from point B it is at 1/3 and from point C it is at 2/3 distance. And as this distance is 1 itself, so 1/3 multiplied by 1, 2/3 multiplied by 1. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we have converted this loading diagram into equivalent diagram. Mind you, this conversion can be done only and only for calculation of reactions. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Some of you would be taking the course termed as strength of materials in next year. Remind that time that while doing some calculations there, you cannot do this conversion. This conversion is only to be done to calculate these reactions. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
You will understand its gravity at that time, not now. But here, as only reactions have been asked, I am okay with this equivalent loading diagram. And now, how do I find out reactions? Tell me. Kaise find out karna hai reactions? So how many unknowns are there in the first place? Tell me. How many unknowns are there? How many reactions are unknown?
Three.
XA, VA and VB. And how many equations of equilibrium do you have? You have three equations of equilibrium. So what is the first equation that we would use? The intelligent choice will be summation of moments about A equal to 0. That will give me the value of VB. So I am doing that summation of moments of all the forces about Z axis. Let us call this as X. Let us call this as y, coming out of the plane of board towards you is z. Summation of moments of all the forces about z axis equal to 0 at point A. So what are the moments of forces? This 900 into 3 is going to cause a clockwise moment about A of amount 900 into 3 into 1.5. So I am going to write it as minus. Minus indicates clockwise moment. 900 into 3 is the magnitude of force multiplied by 1.5 is the perpendicular distance between point where we are taking the moment and line of action of 900 into 3. Happy?
Yes, sir.
What is the moment of this force? It is going to be again clockwise. So I give negative sign. Half 900 into 1 is the magnitude of force. And what is its perpendicular distance from point A? From point A, its distance is 3 plus 1 by 3. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Great. Now, what is the moment of VB? VB, however, causes anti-clockwise moment. So I will have to treat it as positive. So VB multiplied by 3. Happy?
Yes, sir.
This has to be equal to 0. So please do the calculation and tell me the value of VB. I need independent confirmation as well. So tell me the value of VB. Let me also do the calculation with you. So it is 900 into 3 into 1.5 plus 0.5 into 900 into 3 plus 1 by 3 in bracket. Bracket complete.
Sir, I am getting it at 1850.
Divided by 3. Yes, it is 1850. 1850. Correct. So it is 1850 Newton. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And as it is positive, therefore originally assumed sense of the reaction is correct. Originally assumed sense of the reaction is upward, therefore it is upward. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Once PB is found out, let us do now summation fx equal to 0. Summation fx equal to 0 is going to yield the HA equal to 0 because there is only one horizontal force, that is HA. So HA has to be equal to 0. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Once that is done, now we will go ahead with summation fy equal to 0. Summation fy equal to 0 mein kya aayega bolo? 900 into 3. Happy?
Yes, sir.
But negative, because it is in negative y direction. Then minus half into 900. Why negative? Because it is in downward y direction. And plus va. Plus VB, which is, sorry, plus VA, plus VB, VB is 1850. This has to be equal to 0. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So what is the value of VA? Tell me. Yeah,
sir, I am getting it as 1300.
So 1300 Newton. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And as it is positive, therefore originally assumed sense of VA is correct and it is upward. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So this is how we solve this problem. Now, can you read the statement of next problem for me? Go ahead.
A beam is subjected to the linearly distributed downward load and rest on two wide supports BC and DE, which exert uniformly distributed upward loads as shown. Determine the values of WBC and WDE corresponding to equilibrium when WA equal to 600 Newton per meter.
So now WA is given as 600 Newton per meter. Happy? And now the supports, instead of offering the point reaction like shown here, these supports, they offer reaction over a length. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And it is shown as a rectangular reaction. So it is a UDL. So can you tell me what will be the unit of WBC? Tell me the unit.
Newton per meter.
Yes, so this is going to be Newton per meter, as well as this unit is going to be Newton per meter. So let us, this itself is the free body diagram of the beam. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Ye khud hi ek free body diagram hi hai beam ka. We need not do anything else. Now, what is the kind of load that you have here? It is the combination of rectangular and triangular load. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So in a way, it is trapezoidal load. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Trapezoidal load. So how do we deal with trapezoidal load? So we split it into two parts. One is rectangle. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So I will redraw this. Means I will draw the equivalent diagram, equivalent loading diagram here. So we will have a UDL, uniformly distributed load, of how much intensity? 600 Newton per meter. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So uniformly distributed load of intensity 600 newton per meter. And then we have a triangular load. What is the intensity of triangular load here? Can you tell me? If this is 600, then the remaining part is also 600. Do you agree?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Because total has to be 1200 newton per meter. So this is 600 newton per meter and zero here. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Just give me a second. So this is 600 newton per meter and intensity of uniformly varying load is 600 newton per meter at F and zero at A. Happy?
Yes.
Great. Now tell me, this reaction is also a UDL. So what is the total load corresponding to this reaction? Is reaction ke corresponding total load kya hai bata sakte ho?
The WBC into
0.8 into WBC. Do you agree
yes,
with me?
Sir. Yes, sir.
And where does it act? It acts at the centroid. So it is going to act at a distance of 0.4. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So this 0.4 plus this 0.6 is equal to 1 meter. So from 1 meter from here, we are going to have an upward reaction of amount WBC into 0.8. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
At distance of 1 meter. Chalo. Now tell me, where does this load act? It is going to act at the centroid of this 1 meter. So it is going to act at a distance of 0.5 meter. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And this is also 0.5 meter.
Yes, sir.
So this is 3.1 plus 0.8 plus 0.6 plus 0.5. So how much is total? 3.1. Plus 0.8,
sir, 4.6
plus 0.6 plus 0.5. Yeah, tell me.
Sir, it's 5.
It is 5 meters. So from 5 meter from left end, at distance of 5 meter from left end, you are going to have another reaction, and that reaction is going to be equal to how much? WDE into 1. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
W1 into WDE. That's what I have written. Now we can still convert this diagram into the simplified one by converting this UVL and UDL into point loads. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So how do I convert that? So chalo. This entire point, this corresponding to the 600 newton per meter, what is the total load acting on a beam? Tell me. What is the total length? Total length is 6 meter. So 600 into 6, do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
If it is 600 into 6, it is acting at the centroid of this rectangle. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Where is the centroid of this rectangle? 3 meter from the left?
Yes, sir.
So therefore, this distance is going to be equal to 3 meter. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Then corresponding to this 600 newton per meter and 0 newton per meter, this triangular load, what is the total load? Area under the curve. So it is going to be, bolo, kitna rahega?
Half into 600.
Half into 600 into
6. Yes, sir.
And where does it act? From this end, it is going to act at a distance 2/3 of 6. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So this distance, tell me how much it is? 2/3 of 6. So it is equal to 4 meter. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So this distance is 4 meter. Now, chalo, tell me, at 1 meter we have this reaction. So this is 1 meter. So this is 2 meter. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
This is 0.8 WBC. And at 5 meter from this end, So therefore, this distance is going to be 1 meter, and this distance is going to be 1 meter. Happy?
Yes, sir.
It is 1 times WBC. How many unknowns are there? 2 unknowns are there. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir. 2 unknowns.
And we have enough equations. So let me apply the first equation, summation of moments of all the forces about this point. So what is that point? There is no name given to that point. So they have used A, B, C, D, and E. So I will give the name as F here. Happy?
Sir, F is also given at right end.
Okay, so let us use the name G here. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And I will call this point as H. No, not this point. This point as H. No, that point, yes, I can call it as H. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Now, summation of moments of all the forces about Z axis passing through G equal to 0. So, how do I write that? Tell me. 600 into 6 is going to cause clockwise moment. So, 6
minus
600. Minus
600 into 6 into 2.
Into 2, right. Then, what is the moment of this force? Tell me. Clockwise?
Clockwise.
Half?
Half into 600 into 6 into 4. It's 3, right. Sir. Sir, it will be 3. Sir, it will be not 4, it will be 3. We are taking it about G.
Yes, we are taking it about G. So it has to be 3. You are right. Absolutely right. Three, yeah. And we have moment of this 0.8 WBC. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And what is that moment?
Sir, it will be 0.
Yes, because it is passing through G. And what is the moment of WBC?
WBC into 4.
Anti-clockwise.
Yes, sir.
So 4 WBC. Happy?
Yes, sir.
This has to be equal to 0. So that will give me the value of WBC. Can you calculate the value of WBC and tell that to me? It will be in Newton per meter. Yes, tell me.
Sir, it's 3150.
3150, is it? Yes, sir. Or 31.50. Kya hai bolo? 3150?
Sir, it's 3150.
Okay. So therefore, this is 3150 Newton per meter. And now we need to calculate the value of. Oh, in fact, it was not WBC, it was WDE. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
By mistake, I wrote it as WBC. It is WDE. So let me correct that. So WDE, here also it is WDE, and here also it is WDE. DE. And now I need to calculate WBC. So how do I do that? By summation FY equal to 0. Summation FY equal to 0 is going to give me what? Tell me. 0.8 into WBC up. So plus 0.8 into WBC. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Plus WDE up. Therefore, plus WDE, which is equal to
31.50.
But now this is in Newton, because you have to understand that it is WDE into 1. That 1 has a length of meter. Has a unit of meter. So Newton per meter into meter is Newton. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And then what else you have? Minus 600 into 6.
Yes.
What else you have? Minus
half. Minus half into 600 into 6.
This must be equal to 0. So from this, can you tell me what is the value of WBC? Don't forget to divide by 0.8. 0.8 WBC will be equal to 600 into 6 plus half into 600 into 6 minus 3156. And then that divided by 0.8 is WBC. So tell me what is the value.
Sir, it's coming 2812.5.
And this will be in Newton per meter. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And as it has turned out to be positive, therefore, it is going to be upward. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So that's what we have shown. So this was about the solution of two problems based on B. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
We will solve one more problem. I'm going to call it as problem number 62. Ab zara yaad kar do. I'm going to have various loadings on this B. This is called as doubly overhanging B. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Let us say this overhang is 1 meter. This is 3 meter and this is 1 meter. And I'm going to have a loading of this type here. Happy?
Yes, sir.
This is, let us say, 10 Newton per meter. Intensity is, or let us make it 100 Newton per meter. 100 Newton per meter. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Then let us have a UDL here, but upward. Happy? This is, yes, upward UDL. And that upward, okay, UDL, let it have intensity of 20 Newton per meter. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And let us have a uniformly distributed load on this portion, which has the intensity of 1000 Newton per meter. Or let us make it even worse. Let us make it as 4000 Newton per meter. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And now I'm asked to calculate reactions at A and B. So if I have to calculate reactions at A and B, what do I need to do first? So I need to draw free body diagram. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So how do I draw free body diagram? By the way, this is given at distance 1 and 2. So this load does not peak at the center, but it peaks off center. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So let us now draw the free body diagram. How does the free body diagram look like? So this is the first portion, which has a length of 1 meter. On that, which kind of load is acting? Tell me, UDL.
Yes, sir, UDL.
So what is the total load? 20 multiplied by 1. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Where does it act? It is going to act at the centroid of rectangle with base 1 meter. So it is going to act at 0.5 meter. And it is going, yes, to act upward. So therefore, this is 20 into 1 acting upward at distance of 0.5 meter. This is also 0.5 meter. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Then we come to the next part of loading. This is now triangular load. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And what is the total load corresponding to this triangle? So that is going to be the area under this triangular load. So it is going to be half multiplied by 1. Why 1? Because this peak is not at the center of this span. It is at distance 1 meter. So half into 1 into 100. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And where does it act? From this point, it is going to act at the centroid, which is at 2/3 of 1. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So this is going to act at 2/3 into 1. So it is going to act at a distance of 2/3 meter. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Great. Now, what about this loading? Next loading. That is also a triangular load. Happy?
Yes, sir.
What is the intent? What is the load corresponding to this triangle? Half base is 2 meter now for this into 100.
Yes, sir.
Half base
yes.
into 5. And where does it act? It acts at a distance of
2/3 into 2.
2/3 into 2 from here. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So this distance is how much? 2/3 of 2. So that is 4/3. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So how much is this distance? Tell me. From here, how much is the distance? It will be 3 minus 4/3. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So it is going to be 5/3. Happy?
Yes.
So this distance is 5/3. And now, therefore, from this end, this distance will be how much? Tell me. One plus 5/3. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
One plus 5/3. So I have shown these loadings, both the loadings. And what about this? What is the total load acting here?
4000 into 1.
4000 into 1. And where does it act? It will act at a distance of 0.5 meter from right end. Do you agree
yes,
with me?
Sir. Yes, sir.
And what is that load? How much is that load? 4000 into 1. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Now, I will have a reaction at point A. So here I am going to have two reactions. Kon kon si reactions hone wale rehne wale hai batao. VA. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And I am also going to have HA. Because it is a hinge support.
Yes.
So it's our two reactions. Yes. HA and VA. And then at point B, which happens to be at distance 1 meter. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So, ye distance kitna hai bolo? This distance is 1 meter. And at that point, I am going to have a reaction which I am going to call it as VB. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me how much is this distance? So, dekho, this support is at distance 4 meter from left end. Happy?
Yes.
So, this will be 4 minus 1 plus 5 by 3. So what is 1 plus 5 by 3? It is 8 by 3.
8 by 3.
Hai na? So this distance is going to be 4 minus 8 by 3. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we have marked all the distances. Let me now name the points. So I am going to call this point as A. And I am going to call this point as P. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Now, what should I do? I will now take summation of moments of all the forces about A equal to 0 so that HA and VA will vanish and only VB's moment will be unknown. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Chalo. So at this point, I am going to take the moment. Can you tell me what kind of moment is 20 Newton force causes about this point? Clockwise or anti-clockwise?
Sir, clockwise. Yes, sir.
And therefore, I will write it as minus 20 into 0.5. Happy?
Yes, sir.
What kind of moment does this green colored force causes about A?
Sir, clockwise.
It is also clockwise. So I will write it as minus half into 1 into 100. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Into 2/3.
Yes, sir.
What kind of moment does this? I don't know what color that is. What it cause about A? Chalo, bolo. Kunsa moment?
Sir, clockwise.
Clockwise. So how do I write that moment? Bolo.
Half okay, into 2 minus half into 2 into 100.
Into 100. Yes. Into?
Into.
I need only this distance.
Yes, sir.
So 1 plus 5 by 3 minus 1. So this distance is 5 by 3.
5 by 3. Yes, sir.
So this multiplied by 5 by 3. I hope you have understood this. Now, what kind
yes,
of
sir.
Moment does this cause about A? Clockwise?
Yes, sir.
So I will write it as minus. And how much is that moment? 4000 into 1 into which distance I'm interested in? This distance is 3 plus this distance is 0.5. So 3.5?
3.5. Yes, sir.
Multiplied by 3.5. What else causes moment about A? VB. What kind of moment does VB cause? It causes anti-clockwise.
Yes, sir.
And how much is that? VB into 3.
3.
Are you with me? So plus 3 VB.
Yes, sir.
Equal to 0. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So can you tell me the value of VB? I need independent confirmation as well. So how much is VB? Tell me. After solving this problem, we will stop for the day. So do it quickly.
Sir, I am getting is at 536.67.
536.67. 67. Okay, others, please confirm this value. Vedan, can you confirm? Positive, right?
Yes, sir, it will be positive.
Therefore, originally assume since it's correct. I need someone else to confirm this value, then I will go ahead. Please unmute yourself and confirm. Otherwise, I will have to do. So it is 20 into 0.5 plus 0.5 into 100 into 2/3 plus 100 into 5 by 3 plus 400 into 3.5. Whatever is the answer divided by 3. Yes, it is correct. 536.67 Newton upward. Now, how do we find out VB? So to get VB, we are going to do summation FY equals 0. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So tell me what is summation FY equal to 0. So this is plus 20. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Then minus 50. देखो ये 1/2 into 100 is 50, so minus 50, minus 100,
yes, minus 100,
minus 4000, happy?
Yes, sir.
Plus VA plus VB, plus VA plus VB, which is equal to 536.67 Newton, is equal to 0. So can you tell me the value of VA? Tell me the value of VA.
Sir, I am getting it as 3593.33.
Negative.
No, sir, positive.
नहीं गड़बड़ है कुछ तो negative. अच्छा negative नहीं आ रही है value.
No, sir, it's coming positive.
Okay. VB की वैल्यू सही थी ना?
Yes, sir.
Okay, ठीक है. So how much you are getting? Tell me.
3593.33.
Newton. And therefore, originally assumed sense is correct, and therefore it is upward. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Just give me a second. There is some mistake somewhere. It cannot happen. क्या गड़बड़ की है देखो. फोर थाउजेंड इट इज एक्टिंग डाउनवर्ड. ओके जस्ट गिव मी अ सेकेंड. Are all the calculations correct?
Sir, I guess all are correct.
Okay. I will once again cross check it. If there is any problem, I will tell you in the next class. But otherwise, this is the procedure that we use for solution of for finding out reactions of the beams. Are you with me? And this beam is called as doubly overhanging beam because you have overhangs on either side. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so with this we will stop here today and we will start with cables in the next class, most probably the last part of statics. After that we are going to switch to dynamics. So let us close for today. If anyone has any doubt, then please raise it. Otherwise you can leave the class. Use same link for attendance.